I welcome you to this online teaching from Premier Fountain College. This morning, I'm here to take a SS2 class on consumer protection. My name is Mrs. Odedairo, the commerce teacher. We are looking at consumer protection for SS2 class. Then before I proceed, consumer protection is one of the topics we have taught earlier. So we are revising consumer protection this morning. Who is a consumer? To proceed. Who is a consumer? A consumer is an individual who makes the final use of goods and services provided by a firm. Who is a what? Consumer. A consumer is an individual who makes the final use of the goods and services provided by a firm. This we move towards consumer protection. Consumer protection. What is the aim of consumer protection? Consumer protection tries to what? Protect the consumer against exploitation by some seller who may want to offer false credit facilities, low quality and harmful goods, deceptive weight and measures. Yes, that's their aim. Consumer protection tries to do what? Protect consumer against the exploitation by some seller who may want to offer false credit facilities, low quality and harmful goods, deceptive weight and measures. This is the aim of what? Consumer protection. I proceed. We want to look at what? The reason for consumer protection. What is the reason for consumer protection? Number one reason that we are looking at this morning. The first one is what? Low quality or good. Low quality goods. That's the number one what? Reason for consumer protection. What did I say? That's what? Low quality goods. What's the low quality? What does this mean? This is to ensure that goods produced and sold are of high quality. That's number one what? Reason for consumer protection. That the goods produced must be of what? High quality. That they don't encourage substandard what? Production of goods. Then another one we are looking at is what? To ensure that consumers derive maximum satisfaction from commodity they purchase and that they are not deceived by what? Goods with low value. Yes, consumer must what? Have maximum satisfaction. You must derive what? Maximum utility from the goods what? You purchase and not deceived by the what? By the seller or manufacturer. By giving you what? Low value. Take for example, when you open what? A tube of what? Toothpaste. And when you open it, by pressing it, you notice that it's air that was inside. No, this the body, they are there to ensure that all these things are what? Are corrected. So that is the essence of what? The second one, to ensure that consumers derive maximum satisfaction. Then the third one, to protect consumers from what? Dangerous goods, especially drugs, which government places on what? Embargo, because they are detrimental to human existence. There are some what? Goods or there are some drugs that government have placed embargo that they should have been banned from what? From the country. That some manufacturer or some sellers they are bringing into the country. But this body they are there for what? To guide against or to protect what? The consumer from what? Taking these goods. So that is essence, because any goods that is a detriment to human existence, it is not allowed in the country. So that is what? The third one for to protect consumer from dangerous goods. This is the third aspect of what? The reason for consumer protection. Then we move to what? Government legislation. What did I say? Government legislation. There are numerous laws made in many countries aimed at protecting consumers. They include one, Food and Drug Act 1955. Food and Drug Act 1955. What did I say? Food and Drug Act 1955. now today. Let's look at what Food and Drug Act 1955. What are they for? Food and Drug Act 1955. This law makes provision for regulation of manufacturing, sales, and advertisement. What are they for? One, they are there to guide against poisonous goods or harmful substances. Is unfit for human consumption. Any goods that was that are poisonous or harmful will be what will be taken away for human consumption. Then the second one that therefore two goods sold must be properly labeled and advertised. Any good produced in the country must be properly labeled and advertised to the world populace for them to know the manufacturer of such goods. Then the second one is what? Weight and measure. Weight and measure that we have here at 1965. This measure regulates the unit measurement used in trade. That some company or manufacturer that are using substandard measurement. This body they are there to fight against that. They ensure that they give what? Accurate measurement for any goods that what? That are being sold. So that's the essence of this word, body. Then number one, they look at what? Consumer must be protected against exploitation in weight and measurement. That they should have what? Accurate measurement for each product produced. What did I say? They should have accurate measurement for each product produced. Then another one that we are looking at is what? The top one we are looking at is what? Price Control Decree 1970. Price Control Decree 1970. The main goal. The main goal was to control inflation. That is the main goal, was to control inflation by fixing the retail price of some goods, commodities. Yes, we want to look at the price control decree 1970. The major goal was to what? To fix price, to reduce what? Inflation, or to control inflation by fixing the retail price of some commodities. That some sellers that what? They are fixing exorbitant price or charging exorbitant what? Price on what? Particular goods. But this body, they are there to what? To control inflation. They are there to control, to reduce the price to normal rate. The first thing that we do under this body, protection of consumer from paying high price. Protection of consumer for paying high price on commodities. Yes, that is the major goal of this work, of this body. They are to control the price of goods to reduce inflation on fixing of retail price. I think that is that for what? Consumer protection. What I explained earlier, we talk about consumer protection. I asked earlier who is a consumer. That a consumer is a person that makes the final use of what? Of goods produced by a firm. Then we look at what consumer protection, that their aim is to what? Is to protect consumer against exploitation by some seller. Which we look at what? Reason for consumer protection. One, we said low quality goods. Then the second one was to ensure that consumers derive maximum satisfaction. Then the third one, to protect consumers from dangerous goods, especially drugs, which government placed embargo on. At this junction, I will cover it up and move towards the assignment for the day. The assignment for today is